I'm not asking you to brag on me, but you can if you want. What's the best part about being coached by your son?
Being coached by my son, it's been very helpful because you know my weaknesses and you know my strengths. And I can ask you, how should I do this? Or right. And you kind of know my fears as well.
Sure.
You knowing me that well, you help me to push my limits, but yet not to get hurt.
Sure. What was it like starting a new athletic endeavor at 54?
The worst part is remembering the names of the different movements.
Is that the one where your hands are wide or the ones where they're like this?
Yes, because there's so many different movements that you have to do and very specific movements.
It's like learning a new language.
Exactly.
You started CrossFit in June.
Right.
So what was the big catalyst for your like nutrition change in January?
Well, I knew that I was working out 2 to 3 nights a week. But I knew that I was getting stronger, but I wasn't really seeing any changes in my body. But you know, I was addicted to a particular soft drink.
That will remain unnamed.
Yes. Yeah. And so, your brother Andrew had shared with me about a video that he had seen about a mice addiction to cocaine and the sugar and how that they chose the sugar. You know, and also after, you know, Daddy passed away, Emily and your sister said, Mom, I want you to live to be 140. And I thought, there's no way I'm gonna be 140. I'm 54 right now, I'm overweight. I'm trying to get into shape, but it's not working. So I need to do something better for myself. December 28th was the last day that I had a soft drink or any kind of sweet tea. You know, Southerners love sweet tea. From December through March, I dropped 30 pounds and then I've dropped 5 more pounds. And so the workout has become more tolerable, I should say,
right.
With less weight. And, you know, I see a difference in my clothes. And I know I've dropped 2 clothes size since December.
Right.
It makes it worthwhile to know that I'm actually doing something better for my health, as well as it's better for me long-term.
Sure. You had like blood work done at some point?
Oh yeah, yeah. I went to the doctor. I go every 6 months for cholesterol and all of that. And historically, my triglycerides, my cholesterol, the good and bad, HDLs and LDLs have always been out of whack. My last visit, I received my blood work in the mail and absolutely everything, triglycerides, cholesterol, HDLs, LDLs, everything was in great alignment.
Awesome. Yeah.
But seeing it with CrossFit and with decreasing the sugars and getting rid of the sugars, I should say, and just changing diet improved so dramatically that I know that it works.
Right. Do you think you'll live to be 140?
Probably not. But I know at least I will be healthier as I age. I think that's important to be able to maintain core strength and also strength to do stuff for yourself.
Right. I mean, I think independence as you get older is priceless.
Right.
And I mean, I've joked around with people all the time that like if like snatching and deadlifting doesn't make you better at pooping, then it's a waste of time. Right, but that's the point. Is it like, if it doesn't make you better at sitting down and standing up from the toilet, then what's the point? Like, why are we here?
Although sometimes those deadlifts make your butt hurt.
But no, I think you really stuck with it. And the progress has been like drastic. You know, 35 pounds is, we have kettlebells that are lighter than that.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right, and I usually do lighter kettlebells
right.
than that.
Right, right. But no, I think you should be really proud, and I hope you're proud of
what you've
accomplished.
I've got a long ways to go,
yeah.
But I'm glad to see the progress.
Right.